Hey guys, welcome back to Clownfish TV. This is Kneon. I'm here with Geeky Sparkles.
Hello.
And apparently you can sue big tech for being addicted to Facebook and TikTok and Instagram and Snapchat.
That's stupid. That's like your own fault.
You twit face and all those other platforms.
So let me get this straight. I can sue them because I spend too much time on there because I choose to. And they might have things on there to try to keep you there, you know, try to keep you like almost like gambling or whatever.
Oh, it is. Yeah, it is. Yeah.
But I can sue you. It's like if I go to McDonald's and eat McDonald's all the time and I get fat and broke, I can sue McDonald's because I'm fat and broke. It's called, you know, take some of the responsibility and just stop it.
I think people did try suing McDonald's for being fat.
And they probably didn't win because they'd be like...
Like you could have gone to the grocery store and bought a bag of salad. You didn't have to go.
No one told you had to,
you know. You didn't have to go to McDonald's.
You don't have to spend your time on social media. You can go read a book. You can go for a walk. You can go watch shows. You can do something else. You can go have a conversation with somebody in person. No one's making you be on social media. So here you just stop it.
Stop it.
Stop it.
Just stop it. So we're going to talk about this because this person and some of the other people in here look like they are what I would describe as being terminally online. These are the people that are tweeting about 1,000 tweets a day. And then you find out that they're actually on other platforms doing the exact same thing. And
you could go get a job.
You could try getting a job. Yes, you could try getting a job. And the job would probably tell you. No, actually what happens is a lot of these people do get jobs, but they get jobs as like social media managers and stuff. So they're still online all the time and they get paid for it. Let's talk about this. Before we get into it any further, please subscribe for more pop culture, news, views, and rants. Guys, you get a woohoo if you do.
Woohoo!
Shadowbinders Volume 3, you can back it. Go out to shopclownfish.com. You have two days to secure a copy of this hardcover graphic novel coming next summer. First new Shadowbinders content in 10 years. And you can pick up books 1 and 2 as well. Thank you so much for the support. Greatly appreciated. Let's talk about this. BBC. I was addicted to social media. Now I'm suing big tech.
Right. Because, It's that same generation where, it's never my fault.
It's never my fault. It was.
I deserve a trophy for doing nothing, but it's never my fault when I do something wrong.
My parents plopped me down in front of an iPad and said, here you go. And it's never my fault.
Wait. Taylor Little says they were exposed to graphic material at age 11 with no warning. I scroll down Twitter. I used to scroll on Twitter and I'd get exposed to graphic material without warning. It's the nature of social media. Do I agree with it? No. I bet you hope you were on Tumblr before they changed it. Damn.
I can almost guarantee you, let's see, Taylor, was trapped by addiction at age 12, now at age 21. So that would have been this would have been the Tumblr.
Well, apparently
generation.
Being trapped in addiction at age 12 led to they, them pronouns.
I did not.
I'm sorry, but that's a social media. That's a TikTok, especially.
Terminally online. I did not get my life back for all of my teenage years.
So sue your parents.
Sue
for not doing
their
job.
Sue your parents for just parking you in front of the iPad, right? And letting TikTok and Tumblr raise you.
Addiction to social media led to suicide attempts and years of depression. You're going to be really hard-pressed in court to prove that.
Taylor Little's addiction was social media and addiction that led to suicide attempts and years of depression.
Why? Because people didn't like your cartoon?
Probably.
They didn't like your ship?
Didn't like your drawings. Taylor has also now a they/them and describes the tech companies as big bad monsters.
Oh, that's a real big adult thing there. Big bad monsters.
They're... Okay, the company's Taylor believes knowingly put into children's hands highly addictive and damaging products. That is not untrue, but it's also a parent's responsibility to monitor how much time your child is spending on social media. And if your child is terminally online and spending all of their time on social media, especially with a very toxic group of friends that might be influencing their lives outside of social media in negative ways.
Ironically, a lot of the really super toxic, threatening, bullying, load of shit people I've seen have been the self-proclaimed far lefties because they're on there. And if you don't do the cartoon they like or do the drawing they like, they'll tell you to kill yourself. They harass you. They try to get up and find out where you live and try to dox you and all kinds of shit like that. they like, okay, Zoe Saldana defended Chris Pratt, and these same groups of people that were supposed to be so, you know, progressive and accepting were like calling her racist slurs.
And Chris Pratt was so canceled, he got to be Mario and Garfield, you know, so it worked out really, really well.
Right. And yeah. It's like the most toxic, unaccepting group of assholes I've ever seen are these, especially these cartoon stands.
So this is a big lawsuit. They said the lawsuit against Meta, and there's hundreds of families, hundreds of American families are suing for the biggest.
Right, because, you know, parents are going to sue to get, they think they're going to get a payday instead of taking responsibility for the fact you left your kid on the computer and didn't do your job as a parent.
Yes. They said they're suing Meta, which is Facebook and Instagram, TikTok.
Well, TikTok, you know, that's where they're mostly hanging out.
Google and Snap. So Google would be YouTube and Snap, which I keep forgetting still exists.
Yeah, people use that a lot too, yeah.
The plaintiffs include ordinary families and school districts from across the U.S.
Oh, the school districts too, okay.
They claim the platforms are harmful by design. Lawyers for the families believe the case of a 14-year-old British schoolgirl, Molly Russell, is an important example of the potential harms faced by teenagers.
What, because they got cyberbullied?
That's what I think happened. They said last year they monitored an inquest into her death via video link from Washington, looking for any evidence which they could use in the lawsuit.
Name's mentioned by the court of California, okay? And what'd you find?
Well, they said that there were large amounts of material around self-harm, suicide, and depression on social media. Now, here's it's horrible. It's horrible. But the flip side is kids kill themselves, hurt themselves before social media.
Right.
And on some level, I think that it might be better that at least you have a record or an inkling into what their thought processes are, because kids now overshare and they share everything. Whereas back in the day, like, somebody would quietly be suffering with depression or something, and you had no idea. None whatsoever. Now you can look at it and be like, oh, hey, they're posting some really weird stuff on social media. You know, maybe we should be concerned, you know? I don't know. But, they said there was a lack of robust age verification, poor parental controls on these platforms.
God. But you know what? You still went and put it on there, and you knew you shouldn't have been on there, but you still did it anyway.
Yeah. So a judge ruled that, S-230 of the Communications Decency Act, which states platforms, not publishers, did not give companies blanket protection. So this is an issue that comes up. This has come up multiple times around websites, or some websites that are like, yeah, we're probably going to shut down if they keep pushing this, because when it comes to user generated content, like, message boards. In fact, I've seen a lot of message boards, and I can only speculate, but I've seen a lot of message boards lately shutting down after being online for years. Mm-hmm. And now what they're basically saying is, if you publish that content on your website and somebody posts some really crappy stuff, or they're sending DMs using your website or something, you might actually be responsible if they're sending illegal stuff, or, you know, pictures of minors, or, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Whereas before it was like, well, it's user generated content. I can't control, you know, what's being sent. Uh-huh. And they're saying, well, you know, it doesn't give you blanket protection.
Like, Taylor, who lives in Colorado, no.
What?
If it wasn't Colorado, it was going to be
Denver?
Like Seattle, or, you know,
Portland,
or, you know, yeah, San Francisco or something like that. Tells us before getting their first smartphone, they were sporty and outgoing. So you got a smartphone.
Who bought you the smartphone, Taylor?
Right. You got a smartphone and you decide to spend all your time on there. No one did anything about it.
If I had my phone taken away, it felt like having withdrawal. It was unbearable. Literally, when I say it was addictive, I don't mean it was habit forming. I mean, my body and mind craved it.
Well, I'm sure that's completely true. But the thing is, that's just the stuff in general. It's just being online in general, not just on social media. It's just being able to find anything you want to find, watch what you want to watch, then sue, you know, Netflix and Disney and everybody else for having all kinds of, you know, bingeable shows. I'm like, this is stupid. Your parents didn't fucking do their job.
Clearly. Taylor remembers the very first social media notification they clicked on.
Oh my God, seriously?
It was someone's personal self-harm page showing graphic images of wounds and cuts. Why were you looking on that? Who were you following that you got that notification. As an 11-year-old, I clicked on a page and was shown that with no warning. No, I didn't look for it. I didn't ask for it. I can still see it. I'm 21 years old. I can still see it.
Okay, wait. So your argument is the first page you went to was a graphic a personal self-harm page with no warning, but it just happened to just be recommended to you for no reason. No.
Taylor struggled with content around body image and eating disorders.
Again, all this stuff existed before the internet.
Yes. It was like a cult. It felt like a cult. You're constantly being bombarded with photographs of a body you can't have without dying. This was on television, too. Back in the day, there were very special episodes of sitcoms where teenagers dealt with, anorexia and bulimia. And
it wasn't just invented by Taylor.
It was not. And it was something that we dealt with. I mean, geez, when you're flipping through the channels when you're a kid and, you've got HBO and Skinamax and Showtime and you're flipping through the channels and like Hellraiser's coming on and people are being like put up on meat hooks and crap. I didn't sue HBO. I didn't sue Cinemax or Showtime. I think it was on Showtime.
I don't even know.
You know what I'm saying? Like I was like 10 years old. I'm like, oh my God, that guy's on a meat hook.
But the thing is, the photographs and the body you can't have, that has been going on since, as long as I can remember, at least, since like the 60s and 70s and stuff like that, at least probably longer than that. It was, body image and all that issues because of the media. It is an ongoing thing. Do I think that, internet in general exacerbates some of this stuff? Yes. Do I think it's all because of social media? No. I think social medias are a bunch of shit shows. And our kids aren't supposed to be on there all the time either because it's like, it's full of a bunch of shit, especially TikTok.
Yeah. TikTok is definitely a subversive app, I think.
It's not a babysitter.
No,
it was never meant to be a
babysitter.
It's never
meant to be a babysitter. If your kids are on their phones too long, you have parental controls. If you have the account, you can limit the amount of screen time that they have, and it is your right to do so, especially if you're paying the bills. I'd love to know where Taylor's parents were when all this is going down. This is just like blaming video games for school shootings and stuff. Like there's no correlation. It's people that have problems. And, sometimes the problems can be exacerbated or whatever, but there have always been people struggling with depression and body issues and mental illness and sadness and loneliness and isolation. And, it's not because of social media.
This is ridiculous too. We'll go back to what they said in a minute, but that's Molly Russell. They said Molly Russell was from Northwest London, took her own life after being exposed to a stream of negative, depressing content on Instagram. Here's the thing. They recommend what you're looking up.
Yeah.
So Molly clearly had issues before that was on there, and they were giving her probably what she was searching. This is what was coming up.
Yeah.
She had depression and negative effects of online content and in quest into her death. Depression is rampant. I think what the biggest problem with social media is people can't connect anymore. They don't know how to talk to each other anymore. I would honestly say it's more the pandemic. I think it started with social media. I think the pandemic made it 100 times worse.
Yeah, I think there are a lot of, I do believe, and I've said this multiple times, I think social media brings out the worst in people because there's no filter and you're not actually looking someone in the eye and you can get into it with people and you don't know who you're dealing with or whatever. That being said, I think being on social media too much can cause you to be depressed or prone to being sad. That being said, you need to know when to disconnect. And I don't think it's the company's response because you can at any point in time, you can turn your phone off.
Well,
I can't deal with it. It's too negative.
Where are the school programs teaching kids how to communicate and how to disconnect? Where are the, where are the different offerings that are being put out there, for addiction and all that they're trying to, where are the, you're getting sent away for, learning to get off alcohol or drugs or whatever, the rehabs. Where are the rehabs for this? And this is like, if they turned away and turned it off tomorrow, if social media shut down tomorrow, people are still going to be, dissatisfied with their bodies. They're still going to be depressed. They're still going to have issues. It's not going to stop if you take social media away. Do I think it makes it worse? Yes, I do think it makes it worse. But I think it depends on how you use that tool.
I think it's like anything else. There are people that are prone to, addictive personalities, they call it,
Yeah.
I don't know the full psychology, but there are people that are more prone to alcoholism, more prone to gambling, more prone to suicidal thoughts, more prone to, and again, you know, sometimes outside forces, you know, basically exacerbate a problem that's already there. There's an underlying issue. So I would like to know why, again, you said, you know, why this just like pop up in Taylor's, like, did you tell your parents? Did you go to your parents?
Well, I don't know, what was going on in your life before that to lead you? There's stuff going on. You obviously had problems before you went to the internet.
Yes.
It's like, what, you know, and I'm seeing a huge increase in bullying and stuff like that. And people are filming it, which because they're dumbasses. And then, you know, I think that the people, kids are bullying each other more and they're being dicks more. And I think there's a lot of reasons it could be. I think social media, I think there is a problem with kids and social media, which is why all these places say you're not allowed to use it till you're 18, but parents let their kids do it anyway.
Well, yeah, that's the thing too, because I mean, this is a whole thing. They talk about Google and they talk about, you know, YouTube, and this is what kind of caused the adpocalypse was, oh my God, PewDiePie said a naughty word and kids watched it. And I'm watching like on YouTube now, you've got a lot of game streamers that are very popular with kids and they're dropping all kinds of F-bombs and stuff. And influencers are constantly getting into trouble because they're real people, you know, and they say stupid stuff.
A lot of influencers are getting in trouble because they're just dumbass, you know, kids. Like there's like, you know, I'm a, you know, vibe, you know, what did she call herself? The,
the vibe manager
or whatever it was, you know? And then you have other people like, you know, there's a video of some guy that was an influencer hired a bodyguard and was at an airport and getting people's faces because the body, and then people would get mad. The bodyguard would get in their face. It's like, well, that doesn't, just because you're a bodyguard doesn't mean you get to be a shitty human being. This person was kind of assaulting people and getting in their face first. He should have been the one that got, you know, in jail. It's like, that's what they're seeing.
Yeah.
It's like, I don't know, the whole thing. I mean, I can see the other side of it. I truly can. That being said, you really can't say I don't see how you can sue and win because I chose to go on my phone all the damn time. My parents didn't stop it. So I got sad from being on my phone all the time. And now I want to sue and get money. And of course the schools and the people are going to jump on it because they all want money too.
Yeah. I failed as a parent. So now I get to
I can blame it on them.
Now I can just blame it on Facebook. You know,
and get paid for it.
And get paid for it, yeah. So this is what the company said. They said Meta, which is Facebook, said our thoughts are with the families represented in these complaints. We want to reassure every parent that we have their interests at heart and the work we're doing to provide teens with safe, supportive experiences online. TikTok declined to comment.
Well, you know, Meta, I want to say this. I don't buy their safe, supportive experiences because I personally have seen people that are fake accounts going around scamming people.
Oh, absolutely.
And then you report them for violating community guidelines because they're literally a fake account scamming people. And then they tell you they didn't violate community guidelines. So I 100% believe people were probably on there doing shitty things under fake accounts and getting away with it.
Yeah.
I do agree with that.
I have to wonder how many of these people that are in this lawsuit participated in digital lynch mobs.
Uh-huh.
How many of them?
I hope they look at over all their history, their footprint on social media to see if they were personally involved in some shitty things too.
Did you harass people and tell them to kill themselves? Did you try doxing people? Did you, you know, now you're going to cry and be like, oh, social media made me do it. Oh my God. Google says, this is Google, YouTube, the allegations in these complaints are simply not true. Protecting kids across our platform has always been core to our work. Snapchat said the platform was designed to remove the pressure to be perfect. We vet all content before it can reach a large audience to prevent the spread of anything that could be harmful. So they're also saying in this, if you read between the lines, we censor and we're probably going to censor more heavily now because we're being accused of this and it's going to court.
Instead of putting the responsibility on the people who the responsibility belongs to.
Yeah.
There are people out there that make medications for different illnesses or whatever. If you use it in the proper way and you do what you're supposed to do, you're doing it right. There are a lot of people who abuse that. Is it the drug company's fault when somebody else abuses it and they, you know, get hold of it somehow and everything else? I mean, no. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? It's just like, that's stupid. But I guess like with the case of cigarettes, they lost because they said that their advertising was appealing to kids. So who knows? Maybe they'll win.
I don't know.
It's possible. There's been a precedent with cigarettes and stuff like that.
Yeah. So it's like, I mean, this is the thing. They're basically saying that, you know, these companies had immunity more or less. They're like, well, if it's user generated content, we're not responsible for it. Now the judge is basically saying, yeah, you might be responsible for it. And again, I've seen a lot of forums shut down lately. And I think it's just like people are starting to wonder, you know, is it worth it for us to keep this forum active if we become responsible for
dumb shit other people say?
Dumb shit other people say. You know, if it goes to court and it's like, oh, somebody used your private messaging system that you didn't know they were doing and they were sending, you know, lewd pictures to minors or something. You had no way of knowing, because why would you think to look for it? But they were using your platform and your servers to do this. So we're
you didn't know that one person in 10 million was doing that. So yeah. It's your fault.
Yep. And it's your fault. You know, it's your fault.
It's not the fault of the person who is shitty. It's your fault.
Yeah. It's your fault that these two people connected and they had a meetup and then one person wound up dead. That's your website's fault.
It's your fault that Taylor here couldn't get her ass off a phone. I'm sorry, their ass off the phone.
All their asses, yes.
Off the phone.
Yes, where was Taylor's parents?
Exactly, that's what I want to know.
So we're going to wrap this up.
Yep.
All right, guys. Please subscribe for more pop culture news, views, and rants. We'll talk later.
Bye.